We talk a lot about big launch vehicles heading to space, but what about the smaller ones? Firefly Aerospace is getting ready for their first ever launch of their Alpha rocket. If the launch is successful, it could be the breakthrough moment the company's been waiting for.
So in our case, we've decided to attack the small to medium launch market. So Alpha is our first launch vehicle, and it combines the best known older technologies with easily accessible new technologies. Firefly wants to dominate both in the launch vehicle business and the spacecraft business.
Other companies like Rocket Lab and Virgin Orbit also have ambitions to dominate, so the competition is fierce. That's because small satellites like CubeSats hold a lot of potential and can play an important role in the space industry, from Earth observation to defense operations and telecommunications.
We would like to service the small satellite industry and provide services to those larger missions, for example, cargo delivery for human spaceflight. I think it's really the smartest niche because that's the area that's growing the fastest. Small satellites are coming to replace large satellites.
To get to low Earth orbit, these small satellites will be hitching a ride on the two-stage Alpha rocket.
What's different about Alpha is that it's an all-composite rocket. It uses carbon fiber composite. That makes our rocket lighter and stronger so that we can put more payload on the rocket and less structural support than if we were using conventional metallics.
As for the power, the first stage has four Reaver engines, while its second stage has one Lightning engine.
It uses liquid oxygen and RP-1 or kerosene propellants, which are very standard and have been used since the Apollo era.
Alpha is designed to lift up to 1 metric ton of cargo into low Earth orbit, which may put it at an advantage over other small rocket companies.
Amongst our competitors, we are kind of the big small rocket company. So we have a large small launcher, and that 1 metric ton is significantly larger than our competitors.
And Firefly's goal is to make these launches as affordable as they can, which in the space industry means about $15 million. But because this first mission is a test flight, Alpha won't be carrying the usual expensive payloads, like a massive telecommunications satellite. It'll be carrying something a bit more inspirational. Called Dedicated Research and Education Accelerator Mission, or DREAM, the payload will carry 7 projects from groups who typically wouldn't have the financial resources to get a ride into space.
We can provide STEM opportunities for students to fly everything from a small experiment to just some note that they want to distribute up in space. But then there are other small satellite companies in the early stages, and they need a proof of concept, and this gives them a free or very low cost ability to actually demonstrate their product in space, which normally is just out of reach for a small startup company. So DREAM, by its name, is supposed to facilitate people taking things that were in imagination and bringing them to reality.
The rocket was originally scheduled to launch in early 2020, but then the pandemic happened, delaying supply shipments and adding social distancing measures. But after months of tests, their work is finally paying off. The Alpha rocket will launch from California's Vandenberg Air Force Base. And if all goes well with this test, prepare to see a lot more of Firefly.
Space is an adventure, space is a risk. You gotta find people that have that kind of spirit and that kind of determination to go out and do that. Ultimately, I think they're gonna be handsomely rewarded, but they have to be risk takers and they have to really believe in the mission.
For more Countdown to Launch, check out our playlist here. Are there any other launches that you wanna see us cover? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe to Seeker, and thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.